Okay, so now let's look at the Wilder current source. So you can see there is RE here. Now Q1, Q2 are matched, we have assumed. I am taking beta very, very greater than 1, which is general case you will see. So IP will be 0 for both the guys. So you can think of it, this I0 current is flowing through this RE as well because IB is 0. So I can write KVL here, VBE1 minus VBE2 is equal to I0 RE, the drop across this guy. Okay. So if I'll write VB in terms of this current, VBE2 in terms of this current, what you will get? VTLN IREF divided by IS minus VTLN I0 divided by IS, where IS is saturation current, okay, reverse saturation current, and I0 RE is as it is. So this guy we can write it as VTLN IREF divided by I0, IS IS will get cancelled, okay, so it will come in denominator, these two guys, and I0 I bought here. So you can have RE value. And IREF is same as what we had before, VDD minus VBE1 divided by R1. Okay. So mostly what will happen, R1, I0 will be given to you and you will find the value of RE for that I0. Okay. So it will be given to you in the statement that we want this current, this much I0 in this branch. IREF is fixed. R1 will be given. What will be the value of RE for that? Okay, so that kind of questions will be made, designing questions on Wilder current source. Now let's see an example how it will affect the previous circuit. Okay, okay. So let's first take the older circuit, which was our normal first basic current source, current mirror circuit. So here there is no RE. We are assuming beta very, very greater than 1. So IB will be 0. This means whatever current is flowing in this branch will be flowing in this branch, in this branch, in this branch. Okay, same branch. So now it is given that VB is 0.7 volt. It will be same VB for both the transistor. VDD is given as plus 10 volt. R1 we have to find for I0 is equal to 10 microampere. So we want 10 microampere to this guy. So this IREF should also be 10 microampere, okay, because beta is very, very greater than 1. So whatever current here is flowing, it is here also it will flow, and they have same VBE, so this current will be also same, okay, as this. Now we can find the value of R1 by VDD minus VBE divided by IREF. That will give how much? 10 minus 0.7 divided by 10 microampere. That is 9.3 divided by 10 micro mega ohm, or you can say 0.93, or you can say 930 kilo ohm. Okay, so you have seen this value, 930 kilo ohm. Remember this value, okay. Now we will use this X circuit. How to calculate the value of RE? We will see that. Okay, so now let's see when you will add a resistor RE. Now what will happen? Let's say we have IREF is equal to 1 milliampere now, since the both the current will be different. So you can calculate the value of R1. We are assuming this value, okay, 1 milliampere. Then what will happen, you can see R1 will be equal to VDD, which is 10 volt minus 0.7, VBE1 it will be R1 because they will have different VBE, divided by IREF is in 1 milliampere. Okay, so 9.3 kilo ohms. This is the value of R1. What will be the value of RE? RE will be, if you remember, 1 by I0 VTLN IREF divided by I0. This is the expression. So I0 is, we want 1 by 10 microampere. VT we are assuming, let's say for room temperature, 26 millivolt at the rate 300 Kelvin. Okay. So VT, if you plug value of VT, that is 26 millivolts ln IRF is 1 milliampere divided by 10, so 1 by 10. I naught is 10 micro, this is 1 milli. So now you can solve this. So we have R1 value 9.3 kilo ohm. R1 is equal to 9.3 kilo ohm. Now we are calculating for RE. Okay, so if you will calculate this value, what you will get is RE is equal to approximately equal to 12 kilo. Okay, so you have this value for IRF is equal to 1 milliampere. Now, if you will see the first case, this was the second case, by the way. So, on comparing first and second, what you can see is R1 was 930 kilo ohm. Okay, approximately you can say 1000 kilo ohm, or approximately you can say 1 mega ohm, okay, of the range of mega ohm. And whereas in the second case you will see R1 was 9.3 kilo ohm and RE was 12 kilo ohm. So you have reduced the size of resistor from which was required for 10 microampere from mega ohms to kilo ohms, which will require less area. Okay, so that is the difference between first case and second case. So by this example you might be clear with how it affects the resistance value. Although we are using two resistance, but the space required by this guy will be less than the sum of the spaces required by these two guys. Okay, few kilo ohms we just want rather than going for 1 mega ohm. Okay, so that is the difference. So the more the value of resistance, the more will be the area occupied by the in the IC. So that's the reason we go for builder current source for low current. If you want low value of current, so you can see this is in microamperes, this value, and this value is in milliamperes. So which is greater, way greater, they are not equal. Okay, and you can you have seen that how we have calculated the value of RE. So these are the design values. So that's how you approach the questions for builder current source. Okay, now you can also have the it can also be seen as different values we can replicate. Means it doesn't have to be IRF, I naught should not be equal to IRF. If you want this kind of scenario, then we can also use builder current source, because you can see I naught is different than IRF. We are not replicating the current. So if in some part of our IC circuit, if you want different current rather than IRF, then we can use this builder current source. Okay, just put an RE at the emitter and you can have different current here. So when we replicate current is IRF, we have seen that repeater circuit, there we can put one transistor with RE and there you will have different current, and other guys will have same current than RF, like IRF. Okay, so that is how you can see the use of builder. So two uses I said. Okay, first was this resistance value will be less for less current, and second is you can replicate different values of current from IRF. Okay, so